everybody another review from COD Halo Productions. So today we are reviewing the Afterglow AX.1 for the Xbox 360. Now this is a very interesting controller. And it's actually very good. I didn't really get better with the game. I was just kind of stayed the same with games and all. But it does light up, of course, if you didn't know. It has instructions and everything. A nice little cute box, and as you could see, these were the...
Okay, we're back with the in-depth review of the Afterglow Xbox 360 controller. I have to hurry because my video recorder is running out of disk space, so I gotta really hurry up. This does not light up. This is a sticker, which is not as bad. The D-pad is a little bit smaller, but it's pretty hard to notice. And if you're used to the wireless controller, it does not have the battery pack right here. And it'll feel a little bit funny with a lot of room between you. There's an on, off, and active switch. Now, off is, well, off. On is when you turn on the Xbox 360 with it plugged in, it lights up. But if you have it active, it does not light up, but it still works. So, but now I'll turn it off. Very smooth surface. If you look closely inside, you can see the little lights just kind of here and there. Analog sticks move just fine. Back and start are raised up a teensy weensy bit higher, but it is a little bit different. On the front, you can see the little Afterglow symbol, or the little sign they made for it. And it's just very nice. Everything moves just fine. And then up next is lighting it up and actually using it on the Xbox.
Back, and we were with the Afterglow Xbox 360 wired controller. And here is the showing of it. Here's the cable, and of course you have to lift this little up, flap up, and you take the little side of the dot on it and put it in to any of these two. There are two of them. And you plug this in. And there you go. And then it's glowing. This has been a film of COD Halo Productions.